गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ एन आर जांगिड। आई वेलकम यू ऑन माई ऑनलाइन लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म लर्न इंग्लिश विद जांगिड सर। टुडे आई वेलकम द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12th एंड आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड अ लेसन लॉस्ट स्प्रिंग पार्ट 2। द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑलरेडी आई हैव प्रेजेंटेड बिफोर यू। Today we will see the second part of Lost Spring, Class 12th English Core. Dear children, before we start, I just would like to give you a brief introduction of this second part. The author in this lesson, Lost Spring, tells us stories of her interactions with children from deprived backgrounds. Means the children who are unlucky, who do not get proper education in their childhood, and the children who suffer from the evil of child labor. She describes their poor condition and life in an interesting manner. The story touches the reader and is thought provoking. The author described two of her encounters with children from deprived backgrounds. Through them, she wants to highlight the plight, the poor condition of street children forced into labor early in life and are denied the opportunity of schooling. Also, she brings out the callousness, the cruelty of society and the political class towards the sufferings of the poor. The first encounter, dear children, as we have already discussed, is with a rag picker boy named Saheb Alam, who migrated from Bangladesh in 1971 and lives in Simapuri in Delhi. The second boy was Mukesh, who belonged to a family of bangle makers in Firozabad. So the background of this story is Firozabad in Uttar Pradesh, and this town is famous for the glass bangle industry. The boy had dream of becoming a car mechanic, although he was born in the family of a bangle maker, but he had a different dream. He wants to become a car mechanic. On the contrary, his family was traditionally engaged in bangle making, although the profession harmed them physically and they hardly earned any money out of it. His family really, and not only his family, most of the bangle makers in Firozabad suffer from acute poverty. Still, no one dared to dream of doing something else due to the fear of the police and the middlemen. The family elders were content that other than teaching the art of bangle making to their children, they had been able to build them a house to live in. The boy wanted to be a car mechanic. Cars were all that Mukesh had seen on the roads of his town, and so he could not dream any further. So this story is obviously about a boy, a child again, named Mukesh. And he was living in Firozabad, the town famous for bangle making. And dear children, before we go into the text, I would like to just introduce you through a very beautiful video on the life of bangle makers in Firozabad. So first you enjoy the video, then we will discuss the text.
बैंगल्स का ही है। बैंगल्स के बाद यहाँ ग्लास शुरू हुआ है। पहले यहाँ से फिरोजाबाद सिर्फ सेल करने के लिए आया करती थी बैंगल।
पिताजी करते थे पहले ये काम, पिताजी के एक्सपायर होने के बाद में ये काम हमने किया है।
हमारे बाप दादा का और बाप दादे और बाप दादे काफी अर्थ चल रहा है बड़ी काम का।
कर
रहे हैं। जब साल के थे बहुत छोटे थे, काफी छोटे थे। आज हमको कम से कम ये समझ लो, आज हमें काम इस गर्म काम में घुसे हुए आज कम से कम 35 साल करीब हो गए।
तो प्रॉब्लम तो होता ही है, थोड़ा सा गर्मी है उस वजह से।
सेफ्टी के लिए यहाँ कुछ भी नहीं है। सेफ्टी के लिए अगर हाथ कट भी जाता है तो ये सुतलियाँ हैं, सुतलियाँ इनको निकाल लीजिए और यूँ करके बांध लीजिए, खून रुक जाएगा कुछ देर के लिए, फिर फेंक दीजिए। यही पट्टी है यहाँ पर,
यहाँ तो जलते ही रहते हैं, जलने ही काम है। ये काम ऐसा है कि यहाँ कोई किसी का वो नहीं है, आज आ गया कल तो कल दूसरा आ जाएगा, आज मैंने कर लिया कल दूसरा कर गया, परसों कोई और कर गया।
छुट्टी वगैरह पड़ती है, रजिस्टर्ड छुट्टी पड़ती है, त्यौहार वगैरह, इतवार वगैरह, संडे वगैरह, इसके कोई पैसा नहीं मिलता हम लोगों को।
After 15 hours working start हो जाती है। भट्टी में जब कांच melt हो जाता है तो उसको हम लोग लोहे की लबियों से, बड़ी बड़ी लबियाँ होती हैं उससे हम लोग निकालते हैं। लौंग बेलन पे जाती है, उसके बाद उसमें चूड़ी बन जाती है, चूड़ी स्प्रिंग टाइप की चूड़ी बन जाती है। कई तरीके के वर्क्स होते हैं चूड़ी के ऊपर, कुछ जरी का काम करते हैं, कुछ हिल का काम करते हैं, कुछ पॉलिश का काम करते हैं, कुछ लोग ऐसे ही प्लेन भी बेचते हैं, जुड़ने के बाद प्लेन चूड़ी भी बिकती है।
Now, dear children, after watching the video, you must have understood what kind of problems these bangle makers face, how it is very harmful for their health. Now we will see, and this second part is entitled, I want to drive a car. Actually, this is about the dream of Mukesh. Mukesh insists on being his own master. In the first part we have discussed that Sahib-e-Alam, when he started working in the tea stall, he was not his own master, he was working under a master. But Mukesh, he actually wants to become his own master. I will be a motor mechanic, he announces. Do you know anything about cars? The narrator asked him. Do you know anything about cars? I will learn to drive a car, he answers, looking straight into my eyes. Looking straight into my eyes means he was looking with confidence and determination. His dream looms, means seems like a mirage. Actually, dear children, mirage is a phenomena. And in the mirage, it seems that it will be true in future, but actually it will not be. and physically also you can see when on a road of Koltar, when there is a lot of sunshine, and when you look in the distance, it seems as if there is some water, and if you go to catch the water, you will not find any water. So this phenomena is mirage. Here it means that a dream which actually not meant to be fulfilled. So his dream looms like a mirage amidst the dust of streets that fill his town Firozabad, famous for its bangles. Every other family in Firozabad is engaged in making bangles. It is the center of India's glass blowing industry. Glass blowing industry means where the glass is actually melted on a very high heat and then the bangles are produced. Where families have spent generations working around furnaces. A furnace is actually a closed room or a container where heat is produced. Welding. Welding, as you know, the process of joining metal or glass pieces by heating them. So welding glass, making bangles for all the women in the land, it seems. Mukesh family is among them. So Mukesh family is also one of the families of bangle makers. None of them know that it is illegal for children like him to work in the glass furnaces with high temperatures, in dingy cells without air and light. Actually, there is no provision of proper light and proper ventilation. And small children below the age of 14 work in thousands in these factories, and they know they actually do not know that it is illegal. Child labor is illegal. They don't know. And these children, the writer says that the law, if enforced, the law is there against child labor. So if it is enforced properly, could get him and all those 20,000 children, around 20,000 children that time were working in these factories, out of the hot furnaces where they slog, where they actually make their future dark, their daylight hours often losing the brightness of their eyes. Mukesh's eyes beam as he volunteers. Volunteers means by his own wish to take me home, which he proudly says is rebuilt, is being rebuilt. He walks down stinking. The lanes are stinking due to garbage, choked with garbage, past homes that remain hovels, means slum-like homes, with crumbling walls, wobbly doors. The doors are also not very firmly fixed, no windows. Crowded with families of humans and animals, coexisting. They are living together, animals and humans, in a primeval state. If you look at the people who live in Firozabad, you will see as if they are living in a primeval state. He stops at the door of one such house, bangs a wobbly iron door with his foot and pushes it open. So Mukesh takes the narrator to his home. We enter a half-built shack. Shack means a roughly built hut. In one part of it, thatched with dead grass. Thatched means the roof is made of dry grass. Is a firewood stove over which sits a large vessel of sizzling. Sizzling is the sound when we cook something. Make a hissing sound when frying or cooking. Spinach leaves. Actually, one lady is preparing spinach leaves on the ground in large aluminium platters. Are more chopped vegetables. A frail young woman is cooking the evening meal for the whole family. Through eyes filled with smoke. They people don't have gas stove or any other stove. They are working on that that hearth. She smiles. She is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother. Not much older in years, she has begun to command respect as the Bahu, the daughter-in-law of the house, already in charge of three men. Her husband means Mukesh's brother, Mukesh and their father. So the girl in that house, she is not so old in years, and in the communities of Firozabad, child marriage is also very common. So the girls got married at a very early age and they become Bahu, the daughter-in-law of the house, and they got a lot of responsibilities. When the older man enters, she gently withdraws behind the broken wall and brings a veil. Veil means ghungat, A piece of fine material worn by woman to protect or hide the face, cover or hide closer to her face. As custom demands, daughter-in-law must veil their faces before male elders. So this is another evil, the evil of the veil. In this case, the elder is an impoverished bangle maker. Despite long years of hard labor, first as a tailor, then a bangle maker, he has failed to renovate a house, send his two sons to school. All he has managed to do is teach them what he knows, the art of making bangles. Means the father of Mukesh could not do much in his life, although he tried lot of professions, but he did not succeed, and finally he taught his children also the art of making bangles. It is his karma, his destiny, says Mukesh's grandmother, who has watched her own husband go blind with the dust from polishing the glass of bangles. So actually the glass of bangles is very harmful for the eyes. Can a God given lineage, means a profession, ever be broken? They believe. She implies, born in the caste of bangle makers, they have seen nothing but bangles in the house, in the yard, in every other house, in every other yard, every street in Firozabad. Spirals of bangles in different colors, like sunny gold, paddy green, royal blue, pink, purple, every color born out of the seven colors of the rainbow, lie in mounds, in big heaps, in unkempt yards, the yards where they keep, the places where they keep these spirals of bangles are also very dirty, are piled on four-wheeled handcarts, pushed by young men along the narrow lanes of the shanty town, this dark and dull town. And in dark hutments, next to lines of flames of flickering oil lamps, sit boys and girls with their fathers and mothers, welding pieces of colored glass into circles of bangles. So we have seen in the videos how the bangles are made. First they prepare the spirals of those glass, molten glass, and then later on each piece of bangle is they sold it. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside. That is why they often end up losing their eyesight before they become adults. So this is one big health hazard. They just lose their eyesight in a very early age. Savita. Now the narrator is giving example of one more girl. A young girl in drab pink dress sits alongside an elderly woman soldering pieces of glass. One girl named Savita was also joining the pieces of glass. As her hands move mechanically like the tongs of a machine, her hands are working just like a tool, just like a part of machine. I wonder if she knows the sanctity, the piousness of the bangles she helps make. It here, bangles, symbolizes an Indian woman's suhag. In India, we believe that it is a symbol of Indian woman's suhag, auspiciousness in marriage. It will dawn on her suddenly one day when she will also go for marriage, when her head is draped, means covered with a red veil, her hands dyed red with henna, and red bangles rolled onto her wrists. She will then become a bride, like the old woman beside her who became one many years ago. She still has bangles on her wrist, but no light in her eyes. There is no light in the eyes of the woman who is sitting beside Savita. And what is their condition, you see? They say, ek waqt sher bhar khana bhi nahi khaya. They say that they even did not get a full meal in their whole lifetime. She says in a voice drained of joy, means without any happiness. She has not enjoyed even one full meal in her entire lifetime. That is what she has reaped. Her husband, an old man with a flowing beard, says, I know nothing except bangles. All I have done is make a house for the family to live in. Hearing him, one wonders if he has achieved what many have failed in their lifetime. Means many bangle makers could not earn as much money as to make a good house. He has a roof over his head. So that old man is happy that at least he has a house of his own. Now the cry of not having money to do anything except carry on the business of making bangles, not even enough to eat, rings in every home. Means you can hear this complaint of the lack of money everywhere. The young men echo the lament of their elders. Little he is moved with time, it seems, in Firozabad. Years of mind-numbing toil. Toil means hard work. They work so hard before the furnaces, and this hard work actually has killed all initiative, all steps and ability to dream. Actually, they have lost the ability to dream. And if you cannot dream, you cannot make progress in your life. Dreams are very important. Why not organize yourself into a cooperative? So the author gives a suggestion to a group of women, group of men in Firozabad, that why don't you make a cooperative? A cooperative is actually a committee, a group of people where they just decide that they will produce the material and they would sell it, and the profit will also will be distributed in the proportion. I ask a group of young men who have fallen into the vicious circle of middlemen. Actually, they are trapped by the agents who come there to buy the bangles at a very low cost, and then they sell it at a very high cost and they earn the profit. So the middlemen who trapped their fathers and forefathers, even if we get organized, we are the ones who will be hauled up by the police, beaten and dragged to jail for doing something illegal. So they are so afraid that if they do something like making a cooperative, then they will be troubled by police. There is no leader among them. Actually, they don't have any leader. They are not educated. No one who could help them see things differently. Their fathers are as tired as they are. They talk endlessly in a spiral that moves from poverty to apathy. They talk a lot that they are very poor, there is no concern, people don't think about them. They talk about greed of people and to injustice, but they do not take any step to remove this injustice, because they don't have a leader. They don't have the courage to take some initiative. Listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. So here, the narrator is very serious. The narrator says that there are two worlds. Two worlds here means one is the world of the poor people like the bangle makers, and one is the world of the rich people. The poor people work hard, and the rich people who are rich, but they do not work hard. So there is a big gap in the society. So here there are the two worlds, one of the family caught in a web of poverty, burdened by the stigma, means dishonor of caste, in which they are born. Actually, they are considered the people of low caste, the others a vicious circle of the sahukars. So who are in this other world, in that group? The sahukar. Sahukar means the money lenders, the middlemen, the policemen, the keepers of law, the bureaucrats, officers, and the politicians. All jointly they exploit these poor people. Together they have imposed the baggage on the child that he cannot put down. So they are so much burdened. The poet has created an image that it is just like somebody is put under a big burden, and the burden is such that the person is not able to carry. Now he is in a dilemma. He cannot throw it down because it may hurt him, and he is not able to walk with the burden also. Before he is aware, he accepts it as naturally as his father's. To do anything else would mean to dare, and daring is not part of his growing up. When I sense a flash of it in Mukesh, I am cheered. The narrator is happy that somebody from the family of bangle makers is having a dream, like I want to be a motor mechanic. He repeats, he will go to a garage. Now how will it be possible? He will join a garage and learn there the art of a mechanic. But the garage is a long way from his house. I will walk. The garage is not in his colony. So he says, he is so much determined and confident that he says that he will walk to the garage. He insists, do you also dream of flying a plane? Now this is satirical. The author asks a question that do you dream of flying a plane, aeroplane? He is suddenly silent. He says no. He says, staring at the ground, in his small murmur there is an embarrassment, there is some feeling of insult that he has not yet turned into regret. He is content to dream of cars that he sees hurtling, moving down the streets of his town. Few aeroplanes fly over Firozabad. Means aeroplanes do not fly over Firozabad. So the children do not see the aeroplanes. So they don't dream about the aeroplanes. So this is the beautiful story. I want to be a motor mechanic, or I want to drive a car. I hope you understood, dear children. Now these are the textual questions. What makes the city of Firozabad famous? We have discussed about it. Famous for the glass blowing industry. Mention the hazards of working in the glass bangles industry. There are so many health hazards. It is not good for eyes. They lose their eyesight. Even for their skin also it is not good. They develop so many skin diseases. And also the dust of polishing enter into their mouth also, through their nose and mouth. And they also become asthmatic. So this industry is not very beneficial for the health of the people. How is Mukesh's attitude to his situation different from that of his family? The attitude is different because he is a daring child. He wants to do something else in his life, like becoming a motor mechanic. What could be some of the reasons for the migration of people from villages to cities? This is a common question. Why do people come to cities? So there are so many possible answers, so many reasons. One is that mainly they come there in the search of employment, because there are more opportunities in cities. Then the educational facilities are better, health facilities are better, but mainly they come there to seek some good employment, so they can look after their families. What would you agree that promises made to poor children are rarely kept? Yes, definitely. So many promises are made at the time of elections. You see the the agenda of the political parties, their portfolios. There are so many promises to uplift their condition if you see their manifestos, but they are rarely kept. Why do you think this happens in the incidents narrated in the text? This happens because the people are not aware, they are not educated, they don't have their leader, they cannot raise their voice against injustice. What forces conspire to keep the workers in the Bengal industry of Firozabad poverty? So there are so many forces, like the sahukars, like the policemen, the middlemen, the law, people of law, the bureaucrats and all politicians. They are responsible for their poor condition. So, dear children, this is all for today. Thank you very much. Please like, share, comment and subscribe my YouTube channel. And if you have any doubt, any query, you can contact me on my mobile number 9024245156. Thank you and have a fruitful learning.